Seoul, South Korea. The attack that sank the Walsh could not be traced further back than the South Korean National Data Trunk. Drives must be recovered from the entity before North Korean troops get them and use them to justify the invasion and occupation of South Korea. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, played in the style of a tactical assault. Some of you, like, I got that wrong somehow. At any rate, the story thus far is that we have discovered who's actually behind the entire plot to get their hands on the mass kernel-based information warfare algorithms. But somebody attacked the US. They actually attacked the USS Walsh, which was supposedly a very stealthy ship, meaning that they have essentially used a... They've essentially used the mass kernels to target the USS Walsh, because without it, it would not have been possible. So, here's the thing. This is essentially an attack made possible by Shetland, and it benefits both Shetland and Otomo, because, well, it essentially draws the US into a war against its enemies. That would be North Korea and China. And it benefits Shetland as well, since it not only puts the NSA off its trail, but it also drags the US into war, weakening it, which is essentially Shetland's end goal. So this attack was most likely done by the Japanese, because they have their own punch card Dvoraks in the ISDF servers. But that's just speculation. That's the most probable theory that I have. At any rate, the NSA can only trace the intrusion that made the launch of the missile from the North Korean battery possible all the way back to Seoul, South Korea, in the National Data Trunk. Right now, they're thinking that there's a possibility that it may have been the South Koreans who essentially goaded us into fighting their enemies. Played as strict as, but we're here to figure out if that's the case or whether the actual attack came from somewhere else. The actual attack, in fact, did come from Japan, so it was either Shetland's doing or more likely the ISDF's doing, because, well, Shetland servers are in the US, so unlikely that this was Shetland's doing. This was more likely the ISDF's doing. Maybe Shetland was somehow involved. I mean, he is looking to deal the algorithms, the mass kernel algorithms, but maybe he was somehow involved in this plan. But at any rate, it worked out for him, because this gives him ample opportunity to move without having the NSA on his back.
Initial estimates place the combined casualty count for the first 24 hours at... Oh my God. 6,000? Is this a typo?
90% or more of those are enemy casualties. Estimates put our losses at less than 1,000 men.
Less than 1,000? You say that like it's a good thing.
Sir, it's paranoia. Our saber-rattling has their leadership in a panic. It's a preemptive strike. Our own intelligence indicates that they didn't launch that missile intentionally. And until we can prove it, Seoul is on the block.
What are our military options for holding the city?
No reasonable strategic assessment has ever claimed it was possible without nuclear capability. And if that's the way it has to be...
38 hours ago, the NKA committed to open war on the Korean Peninsula. We've known for 50 years that their objective would be to capture Seoul within 72 hours. It appears they have a real shot at it. South Korean and U.S. forces are using orchestrated retrogrades to channel individual NKA divisions along discrete corridors. 6 hours ago, the first of those divisions reached Seoul and is seeking to capture critical infrastructure. High on their list is a telecommunications switching station north of the city. Unfortunately, the IW attack that sank the Walsh came through this switching station. If the NKA gets their hands on that information, they'll be able to justify their invasion and possibly force the world to allow them to hold the country. We need to get that information before they do.
That's true.
The information warfare attacks that launched the missile that sank the Walsh came through Seoul. I wasn't able to trace them back any further than the switching station, and I don't even know for sure that they didn't originate there. It's entirely possible that South Korea has manipulated us into war by forcing the North to attack the U.S. I would just try and hack my way in, but this is a fat, secure data pipe, and damage caused by the fighting has already isolated most of the entry ports. You need to get in there and recover the data manually, then broadcast it out point to point so we can take a closer look.
CIA maintains several safe houses in Seoul to facilitate insertion of agents and recovery of possible defectors. Usually, they're set up to look like ordinary residences. I'm currently working out a plan to have you forward inserted into one of these safe houses before 2ID performs another major retrograde. Once you're in, our boys will retreat, and the NKA front will overrun and bypass your location, leaving you in the wake of the main force, but still in advance of the support troops. You'll have a small zone of comfort, and I would strongly advise you not to stray from your AO. You don't want to encounter a battalion-sized force.
Do I read this industrial
crate? USS Ronald Reagan is ready to launch an EA-6B Prowler rigged with a point-to-point laser receiver rig. Your man will be given a special transmitter that will track the plane and transmit the data. This comm setup is 100% secure. Nothing is broadcast, so nothing can be intercepted. Never mind decrypted. Once your man is in position, we'll send in the plane and get the data. But this is still a highly risky operation. Whatever you're promising me better be worth it. These planes are worth $60 million, you know.
I think I do, sort of. I've heard you say that a few times now. Alright, pretty simple, straightforward. Nothing too fancy here. Although this is a long mission. And yeah, let's see how quickly we can get through this when we're playing it. In the assault mode. Alright, let's go.
Welcome to the three-block war, Fisher. The main advance has bypassed your position. It expects sporadic fighting among units separated from the main force.
Whose side am I on here?
Your own. You're not a legal combatant. Anyone who sees you will attack on sight, friend or foe.
Listen, there aren't any alarms to worry about, but anyone you encounter will probably already be alert.
I'll be careful.
Oh well. In a playthrough where I need health, I just lost it. Probably should have been careful.
Fisher, critical update. I have other assets on the ground not far from your position.
Another splinter cell?
Splinter cells in training. They're on a black bag op. Their target was just relocated by NKA special forces.
So I need to bring in the target?
No. You need to interrogate one of those special forces to find out where they took him.
Okay.
Don't kill them before you talk to them or I'll pull you out.
Right then.
Hora. Ichi demis. Namaru no masu. Kironika. Yogiga odiyara. Unjonal te kesok chidoru boku isoseya. Chidoru yoshimi boji hanana bone. Araso. Uriga odinnje almyeoneun araso chare borago. Naneun ojumina nugo bol teniki. Kireul ido boriji marao.
I finally got the shotgun that I've been looking for all these days. Come with me then. We have a few words to exchange. After that, I'll be killing you. Alright.
Stay quiet and you might live.
What? Oh!
Shut up. Lambert, I've got one.
Good job, Fisher. I'm gonna patch you through direct. Hold on.
Stay calm. This'll just take a sec.
Okay!
All right, Fisher. Go ahead.
I've got someone who wants to talk to you.
Roger. Ask him where they took Jung.
Where did you take Jung?
I don't know what you're talking about.
He's not answering. Should I kill him?
Negative.
All right. They say I should kill you, so...
Wait! Okay! Jung, we moved him to a cyber cafe just off the fish market by the river.
Is that what you needed to know, guys?
Affirmative. Thanks a lot, sir. We owe you one.
Welcome to the team. You want to tell me what's going on, Lambert?
Sorry, Fisher, but you're getting too old for this kind of work.
Stop listening to Grim. If you go by her definition of old, you'd need to issue diapers with every set of goggles.
If I listen to you much longer, it'll be adult undergarments.
That was cool.
I like how the life fades away from their bodies. In the thermal. And I finally got the shotgun attachment that I was looking for. Could not be happier. Now, do I... Well, I don't see the harm. Let's try. Let's try using the shotgun on this guy. Come to me. Ooh, that was bad.
Good thinking, Fisher. Shut down those propaganda broadcasts and our boys will be in better spirits.
Our boys? I'm just doing it because it's annoying.
And, I suppose it is good to be eliminating the North Korean forces since they are the enemies after all. Although, I don't know how much Sam believes in enemies.
Sam, a Predator drone just spotted a mobile command center in the area up ahead. See if you can tap it for intelligence.
You don't want me to take it out?
No. We could have done that with the Predator.
That's true. Now, here's where I want to start exploiting this mod. I wonder if I have like a sniper attachment for this as well. Or just a shotgun. I do, I have two attachments. That's amazing. Now, these guys aren't special forces. The ones that we're about to face, I mean. Actually, I would rather prefer to use this instead. And it's nice that we've even got stuff like wall mines. Alright then. Time for me to maneuver around. Get the drop on these guys. Now, can I get like a 2-for-1 here? Apparently not. Good thing about this level is that you don't really have any alarms to worry about. Shotgun shells, let's go. Oh yeah, the mobile command center. Totally forgot about this.
Good job, Sam. With an inside line on the NKA's command network, we should be able to funnel useful intelligence to the regs.
Always happy to lend a hand.
Good job, Sam. There's only one more propaganda broadcast set up in your area.
Right then. So, in order to get to that, we're gonna have to climb up that way. And I guess I'll be going in through this place itself.
Fisher, that's the last of their propaganda stations in this area.
Thank God. Starting to lose my mind.
So, the next section I want to deal with it by setting some traps. There have been no alarms yet.
Fisher, those are the main servers for the national data trunk. Every bit of data that moves through here gets tagged in transit.
Yeah. It's smaller than I thought.
And getting smaller every year. Listen, you need to recover the main drive so I can see if the attack that launched the missile came from somewhere else first. Good. Now get that drive up to the roof and we'll transmit it to the EA-6B.
Why can't you just read it from here?
It'll take too long to guarantee a secure link. And if the DPRK intercepts it,
then this mission is a waste of time.
Good job, Sam. You catch on quick, don't you? I wonder if any of those wall mines blew because of that. What's up? Why are you so afraid? Well, that actually worked out better than I anticipated that it would. Time to equip a frag grenade for these guys here.
Okay.
I guess that took care of them. What's going on? Excuse me. Oh, I guess my game's lagging. Hold up. Yeah, my game seems to be lagging hard because the power just went out, and yeah, essentially that. Let me just sit in here until... Oh, right. I need to get rid of the body first. Enemies don't always react to stuff like this. They only do it sometimes. Do we have a... Yeah, a medkit right here. Toilets usually have medkits. Right then. Time to use the elevator and go upstairs.
Next stop, top floor.
Once I transmit the data, I'm on to extraction?
That's the plan. If we can confirm the LZ is safe, we'll extract you directly from the rooftop.
And if it's not safe?
That's like a bit of foreshadowing there. And if it's not safe? Because it's not going to be safe. I mean, the LZ is safe, but the plane gets shot down. So, South Korea. The data from the entity was successfully transferred back to Third Echelon for analysis. Unfortunately, the plane that was rebroadcasting that information was shot down before it could be pushed. The data must not fall into North Korean hands, and that's essentially it. Now, the issue right here stems from the simple fact that it's just an issue with the narrative, from what I can see, is... They were using point-to-point communication so that the data could not be intercepted and decrypted so that it's safe. But then the plane goes ahead and just broadcasts that information to the Third Echelon anyway, which is sort of strange. It does not make sense. So, yeah, I mean, that's a huge liability right there. Anyhow, we must now erase that information or recover it, essentially.
Lambert, I'm in position.
Firefair, this is Moondog. Begin transmission now.
A problem.
Fisher, the plane went down before they could purge the data. You need to get to the wreckage and make sure the North Koreans don't recover it.
NK regulars are setting up portable radar reconnaissance receivers. See if you can take them all out.
Right, so a thing about these things.
Sam, it would be helpful if you could recover the technical specifications on these new North Korean UAVs.
Those things can actually be taken out by the sniper attachments. I mean, you guys saw it explode, right? Now,
good
just
job,
shoot that
Sam.
Thing.
RF monitoring indicates at least 4 more P3Rs active in your AO.
going loud and proud there. Okay, let's go ahead and use this pistol here and get rid of that thing. And maybe that light as well. It sort of gives us away. Since that drone is out of the picture right now, we don't really have any drones for the time being that are going to be trouble for us. I don't know whether there's... I don't think there's a way to go anywhere from there. Maybe we can try. Yeah, there's no way to go anywhere from there. I'd rather have an area where I can pivot around before I begin my assault on these guys. I'm almost set. Need to play this next section really tactically if I do not want to die. Actually, you know what? Yeah, let me just go ahead and switch up to the sniper. That's good. That's better. Far better. Might as well just take this out from here itself. Wait, did I take that out yet? I think I did. I wouldn't sweat it even if I did not. I'll just let that body be there. And I do not think there are any health kits right here. Pretty sure there is one up ahead, but not in this area. Okay, next section. Excuse me. Thank you. That went boom.
Sam, we have RF confirmation that there are only two P3Rs left in your area.
Of course. There would only be two left. Do I wanna... That guy said. I'm trying not to fall off, essentially, because it's pretty easy to fall off from this section here. And die. Which is counterproductive. Since I already have very little health left. I think the bomb just fell inside. Like, there's a bomb inside that. I think it just fell down there. I mean, I know of a... Are those people down there? I cannot tell yet. Let's see.
Nochotta. 그냥 사라져 버렸네.
It's strange that the bomb still did not explode. But oh well. I'm not really gonna sweat it. Whatever happens, happens for the best, they see. The section up ahead is where I'm a little nervous. It's like a section that I'm a little nervous about, because there's a South Korean guy up ahead and I do not want to tangle with him. That guy's right there. I can probably take him out from here. Yep. With that out of the way.
Whoa, good grab, Sam. Looks like the complete technical specifications on North Korean UAVs.
So what, we can just switch them all off now?
Ha, no. But we can pass it up the chain and inside of a few months find ways to disable them.
Well, that's not much help to me then, is it?
Yeah, no use for me. What? Why does Sam have to make it so dirty? He's just having some health kits. But he goes like, yeah, baby. Okay. Oh no. Maybe I should Wait, do I not have any stunning attachments to use? Come here. I don't want to interrogate you, I just want to knock you out so that you're not in the way, since you are an ally and everything. There always isn't a guy right here. Sometimes he's there, sometimes he's not. It's more of a toss of the dice whether he'll be there or not. Frag grenade, 1. Frag grenade, 2. And 5.56 ammo. Oh, 5.7 ammo for the pistol, which I don't use at all. Alright, moving on. Pulling my gun out in case there's something around the corner.
Sometimes there is. We have multiple reports of more active armor in your immediate AO.
Great.
That's essentially them suggesting that we take out the active armor. Interesting. Okay, time to get slow. One of these guys got eliminated. And we are in the shadows for now. Nobody will be able to see us anymore. Next section up ahead is also pretty difficult, taking out the tank, I mean. But let's see how easy that is for us. Did these guys literally just stop fighting just to try and figure out who's there? I guess that hit. I can't even see this guy from here. Oh well. That's not good. That's not good at all. I cannot see that guy from here. I guess there are some downsides to using like. Down here? Nah, that's not gonna work. Tank can totally see me, and that's the main issue right there. Maybe if I toss it there. One of those guys died, I don't know why. Tank behavior seems to have gone back to normal now. I can't tell if the tank could see me or not. Sometimes it looks like it could see me, sometimes it looks like it can't see me. And I'm honestly having a hard time deciding. But I am going to take this tank out one way or the other. Might just need to get up. Boost for that. All right. That leaves just you, Tack. Just you.
One more P3R to go, Fisher.
I'm fine.
I know you will, Sam. You always do. Boy, that was hectic. I did not expect it to be that difficult, that tank. I mean, what is this? 20mm? Ah, we don't even use 50BMG with our sniper. We use literal 20mm. God damn it. But that's something else altogether. I'll need to be really cautious with the next section. Can't even afford getting hit by a single shot. Okay, night vision's off. Sniper mode on. Okay, that looks lovely. Holy shit, that looks lovely. And so basically, you can only reload the sniper attachment one by one. You can't exactly, like, just keep putting bullets in there. You have to take your time doing it. Don't know where the other guys are. Probably somewhere over there. But, yeah. I can't see them, basically. I would rather be a little cautious if I were you, son. We do have a sniper after all. Alright. You sound like you're somewhere close by. I can't tell where you are though. Which is the major hassle right now? Figuring out where you are. Probably over there, because this area only has 3 people, as far as I remember. And no alarms. This level has no alarms, even though they do have an alarm indicator put on. Alright, that's done. We don't really need to do this, I'll avoid doing that anyway. Armor has broken through. Right then, saving. Don't know who's shooting where, but oh well. I'll be going upstairs first. You can actually take that thing out from down there itself, or you just need to shoot up here. And you've officially taken this thing out. But what I would like to do first is take care of the tank. And to that effect, Let me just go ahead and switch over to the shotgun attachment set. Hi there. Would you like it to see?
Way to go, Sam. With those P3Rs out of commission, it'll be a lot safer to extract you.
Wow, you mean you're actually planning to get me out of here alive one day?
Yeah, one day, just not today. I see you're all over with me. Pretty sure there are more folks down there. I just need to check this factory lead down the hatch there. And we'll be golden. Whoops.
Good job, Fisher. You seriously impaired North Korea's armored advance.
Did I know? Oh, they're there, guys. And what I love about this game is how the shotgun is actually effective at longer ranges. Now this time around, just for the
Sam,
sake of...
you need to get to the plane and try to recover that data before we can extract you.
Right, totally walked right past it. That's my bad, Lambert. My bad. I'm just reloading shotgun because I figured out how to do it. It's fun. Alright then. Now, just for the sake of variety, I'm not going to be saving the pilots this time around.
The plane is too badly damaged to recover the data. You'll need to fall back and designate the target for an airstrike. Use the structure down the street for your platform.
Let me get the pilots to safety first.
We don't have a lot of time, Sam. An NKA recovery team is en route.
Are you ordering me to leave these guys here and call in an airstrike?
I'm telling you what the objective is, trusting you to complete it. You have your orders.
Now this is where it's essentially a dilemma, but if you actually go ahead and designate the plane from here, you get a different dialogue.
God, forgive me.
All right, Fisher, we have an F-117 inbound. Stand by.
Roger, target is painted.
Hello there, paperboy. This is Postman. We have your glare. Stay on target.
Affirmative, Postman.
And there you go, paperboy. The package is in the mail.
Confirm visual on the package, Postman.
Have a better one. Postman out.
Oh no. Those poor souls. And that was that from Mission Seoul. I mean, it was a diversion in every respect of the word, and in every aspect of the word. And well, we could have actually saved the pilots as well and gained like an additional bonus objective to complete, or maybe saved one to just lower our score further. But we decided to not do that, just to, you know, for the sake of variety in gameplay. Sam says a few things. In case, you know, you don't exactly save the pilots first. But we got identified as an intruder twice, probably when we decided to go loud and proud. In the second half, most likely, one enemy knocked out. Actually, that wasn't really an enemy, but more of an ally. An enemy injured. Okay, we did not actually kill everybody. That is interesting. There's still some person who we have not eliminated in a firefight, but we put some bullets in them and just let them go. That's quite interesting to know, actually. 21 enemies killed, and yeah, no civilians here. 3 bodies were found, 36% mission score. I'm sort of satisfied with that. Probably because we killed so many folks and 3 bodies were found, that our mission score is so low. So that actually, the data that we recovered from the national data trunk essentially places the blame on Japan. Now, coincidentally, Shetland is also found in Japan. However, I mean, I'm pretty sure he will not be lugging the punch card machine around. So that's more or less just foreshadowing the fact that Otomo is involved in all of this. And it's basically the Japanese ISDF that enables the entire attack on the US, trying to goad it into war against its enemies. Since it can't do it itself, it's just having somebody else do the dirty work for them, while its own slate remains clean and it doesn't, you know, violate its own restrictions or prohibitions, its post-World War II prohibitions. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's what we gather from this level. They don't tell you that right now, but they will tell you that in the briefing for the next mission, which is Bathhouse, which is, in my opinion, the dramatic finale of this game. But yeah, the next level is just tying up loose ends, honestly, in pretty much the fashion of things as far as Splinter Cell games go, at least the original trilogy went. The latter trilogy typically does not have that level. Double Agent has it, but you need to jump through some hoops to unlock it. At any rate, that was that for Mission Seoul. The next time we come back, we will be covering Bathhouse. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.